Oh Gott. I played this 2 weeks ago. Okay. Good luck. Fuck. Oh. Oh my god. I don't like this. Hold on. I also have
Wintermute. Good luck.
a Steam overlay. Oh fuck. I don't know how to. This is dark. There's no options here. I hate this. Bring on the ghost. You missed the speed dating already. Okay, I don't like this. This is too dark. I
Serendipity
cannot
sync.
actually see
By
anything
the
right
way,
now.
yes, it is always this dark.
Oh, fucking shit. I'm gonna die. I'm gonna fucking die. I don't know anything about this game. And I'm using a mouse and keyboard to control it. That's a jump? Okay. I can't interact with any of this stuff. Oh, I like how my Steam overlay is captured here. What the fuck? Okay, well, nothing I can do about that then. My mouse just stopped working? Cool. Okay. I hate this. Saw your friends list earlier. Oh, great. Cool. I don't think I think I removed everyone's like names and stuff. Oh, I can pick this up. Okay.
In the psychology of the modern civilized human being, it is difficult to overstate the significance of the house. Since as early as the Neolithic era, humankind has defined itself by its buildings. Buildings for worship, buildings for socializing, buildings for protection, even buildings for the commemoration of the dead. But of all the structures that mankind has invented for itself, there is little doubt that the house is that which it relies upon most completely for its continued survival.
There's a tape in the dining room. Great minds think alike. Spoon. Wait, isn't this the dining room? Guess it's just the kitchen. Okay. No, I can't do anything there. Fuck, Good, doors opening. Gives me a heart attack. That's cool. That's very cool. That's a thing I love. I'm gonna fucking die! Can you date ghosts in this game too? I fucking wish.
The house is one of the key elements that separates modern humanity from its more primitive antecedents. No other creature goes to such lengths to create lasting, permanent shelter for itself, nor regards said shelters with such reverence and import. Why do human beings of our modern age foster with tremendous sympathy toward their homes? There are many reasons, of course, but perhaps it is due in some small part to seeing them as a reflection of ourselves.
There's a tape in the downstairs bathroom. There's seriously no options here. I can't fucking do anything. Okay. Downstairs bathroom, is that said? Okay. Let's close that door. This isn't the downstairs bathroom, right? Oh, it is a bath. It is a bathroom. Toilet.
The anatomy of the house is such that this analogy is less superficial than at first it may seem. To carry it further, if we were to dissect a house as we might a human cadaver, we would find ourselves able to isolate and describe its various appendages and their functions in a decidedly anatomical fashion. There is even a fair number of direct comparisons to be drawn between those organs of a house and those of a human body.
I don't like this. Keep in the garage. I can't see shit in that room. This is the garage, right? Wow, I actually, like, I think you guys can see more than I can. I have a glare from my light on. Is this not the garage? On the floor? I just don't see it. Where the fuck am I going? Okay.
For example, let us examine the living room. Often the dominant space of a house is ground level, as well as typically the center of activity in a well-populated home. The living room is very much the heart of the house. While a human heart circulates blood to oxygenate the body's extremities, the living room circulates people, activity, communication. It is the room most likely to be found beating, as active and vivacious as its name would imply. The comparison is only strengthened when we consider also that the living room is most commonly the room to contain the fireplace, making it additionally a locus of actual physical heat.
Okay. There's a tape in the living room. Okay, cool. This Steam overlay is pissing me off. Oh, cool. That just... not supposed to be capturing the Steam overlay! Anatomy. Man, come on. Yeah, everyone beats in the living room. Okay, fuck it. I guess I can't. I have to deal with this. I can't do anything about it. This is too dark. Okay. I'm gonna fucking die when something scary happens, guys. This isn't widescreen, also not full screen. Yeah, I know. It asked me for display resolutions and I'm like, okay. But now it's like, why is it like... Give me a second.
Game plugs in. Oh, okay. Properties transform. Can I not grab this and pull it? Man, okay, whatever. We're just gonna have to deal with this. It's fine.
It is easy to think of the kitchen and dining room as the stomach or digestive system of a house, though this comparison is tenuous. By contrast, the function and analog of a bathroom should be immediately obvious. The hallways and corridors of a house are its veins, providing circulation coursing throughout its frame. A staircase bears more than a passing resemblance, both physically and symbolically, to a spine. The windows of a house serve much the same purpose as eyes, and anyone who has ever rounded a bend or a long drive and come suddenly face to face with a tall, dark manor will tell you that it is difficult to shake the impression that the house, through its lightless windows, is a creature capable of vision and intelligence.
Keep on the stairs.
The bedroom is perhaps the room that most eludes direct comparison in this fashion. At a stretch, and allowing for a bit of poetic sympathy, it might be said that the bedroom is not unlike the human mind, or those parts of it which dictate thought and imagination. In the bedroom, dreams are dreamt, passions are ignited, epiphanies are experienced in cold sweat at early hours. In the bedroom is where people invariably spend the majority of their time, though comparatively little of it whilst conscious.
You just go around collecting tapes. I'm sure something bad is gonna happen. I don't trust this. I mean, I don't think I'm meant to fight anything, but I think I'm gonna get jump scared. Oh, motherfucker. How many fucking rooms are there upstairs? Oh my god. Okay. Problem is I can't see what I'm walking into. Well, that's very out of place. That purple bedspread. Fuck, I hate this.
And yet, this analogy is an incomplete one, for obviously the mind is an exceedingly complex thing. If the bedroom represents the thinking, dreaming part of the brain, then it is the basement that represents those lower, unconscious parts. The basement is dark. It is buried. It is a place full of cobwebs where memories are stored. A poignant comparison, truly. Often the unnerving uncertainty that comes with considering the deeper aspects of the human psyche is not unlike gazing down at the swimming blackness pooled at the bottom of a basement stairwell. It is a place we spend our childhoods filling with monsters that will lay for years in patient silence. It is a place that, barring some specific errand, we seldom ever want to go.
Of course there's a tape in the basement. Of course there's a tape in the basement. Is this the basement? I'm going to fucking die! Oh! No! Can't see shit. Fucking hate this.
Wintermute. Boo.
All right. Ape, or is it something else? I can't tell. Why is it on the wall like that? Where's the staircase back up? Okay. That's real. I can't believe that's quote 69.
Of course, this comparison, though appropriate, is a very heavy-handed one. And often the basement is little more than a storage space littered with the corpses of spiders and wood lice. While poets and psychoanalysts no doubt dread the thought of a dark basement, in truth, it is the bedroom, the waking mind, that place of dreams, that is actually the most frightening of all.
I hate this. I hate this. I hate this. I'm gonna cry. I'm gonna cry. I don't know what I'm gonna see. I'm gonna cry. This room is very red. Oh. That seems moving. No, it's just a bit. Fucking hell. Oh. Oh.
It is here, in the bedroom, that we are at our most vulnerable. Each night we shut our senses to the world for hours at a time, trusting in the house to keep us safe until next we wake.
Serendipity sink.
In this state of extreme vulnerability, we will spend something like 20% of our lives.
Oh fuck.
Anything might stand beside us. Ah! Keep us company until dawn, and we would never perceive it. We can only pray that the house will not let such things carry on as we sleep. In this way, during these hours, the bedroom seems less like a mind and more like a mouth. For it is here that the house is most likely to betray us. It is here that we place ourselves most at the house's mercy and spend each night hoping that it will not bite down.
What? Oh! What? The game just closed on me. Okay, hold on, hold on, hold on. Reopen? Okay. Play it again? Fuck. Fuck. Was it supposed to crash? I'm thinking yes. I'm thinking yes, that is the case.
Psychology of the modern civilized human being, it is difficult to overstate the significance of the house. Since as early as the Neolithic era, humankind has defined the era of the dead. But of all the structures that mankind has invented for itself, there is little doubt that the house is that which it relies upon most completely for its continued survival.
I don't want to keep playing this. Because I can't fucking see anything! I can't see anything! And I... In the mouth of the house. Oh.
Why do human beings of our modern age foster this tremendous sympathy?
I promise you there's no jump scares. I don't know. The faster you find the tapes, yeah, that's true. What is going on there? What doors are unlocked? Oh, but where? What about the front door? Of course the front door is not unlocked! Okay, but wait, now what? Is this still the same? Fuck, I don't want to do this. I guess I have to go into a room I haven't been in yet. Because it said the doors are unlocked. Where were there other doors that were unopenable? Fuck, I hate this. Was there a door in the living room? Oh, it's just another entrance into the dining room. Okay. Upstairs? Oh, Wintermute. Is that a glitch? Is that intentional? There's nothing in here. Where the fuck is the tape? Where's the tape that I need? Fuck you, disappearing painting. There's a tape player here. Oh my god. Okay, so there's a tape player there, but no tape. it! Fucking hell! Fuck you, cursed ass room. I don't know if these glitches are supposed to be part of the game, or they're just, like, glitches with the game. That VCR static's getting worse.
It is easy to think of the kitchen and dining room as the stomach or digestive system.
Just the tracking. Yeah,
this
right.
Comparison is tenuous. By contrast, the function and analog of a bathroom should be immediately obvious. The hallways and corridors of the house are like veins, providing circulation coursing throughout its frame. A staircase bears more than a passing resemblance, both physically and symbolically, to a spine. The windows of the house serve much the same purpose as eyes.
Yes, what I was thinking too.
The windows around
the
bend in a long drive and come suddenly face to face with a pale, dark manner will tell you that the house is a creature capable of.
Didn't give me any more instructions. Okay, so like master bedroom though again? Fucking shit! I hate this! I don't want to go in here! Oh! No! Heard you like doors, so we put a door inside of your door. Oh, the light's on. Okay. Sure!
Casual slam jam. No one has ever died in a house.
Thank you, casual slam jam. I want to cry.
The bedroom is perhaps the room that most eludes direct comparison in this fashion. At a stretch and allowing for a bit of poetic sympathy, it might be said that the bedroom is not unlike the human mind, or those parts of it which dictate thought and imagination. In the bedroom,
I dream that there are teeth growing all over me. Everywhere on me and in me, like cysts or bone spurs. They're loose, but I can't move them because I have no hands. I look out through the bedroom window and I see a truck approaching. A young man steps out, approaches, and enters through the front door. His body is covered in swollen ticks the size of quarters. He's walking through the downstairs hallway and laughing. He begins urinating on the wall. He spits on the carpet. He's moving through the first floor, breaking and upsetting things. He goes to the basement and stands at the top of the stairs. I'm angry at him, so I slam the door and he falls down. I can feel his bones snapping. The ticks are bursting, oozing old black blood everywhere. I can feel him being ground up, dissolved and torn, splitting and shredding. I leave the door closed. I close my eyes and try to sleep. The teeth continue growing on me until there is nothing left of me but teeth.
The basement is dark.
There are no subtitles. No, I didn't alt F4, the game closed on me. Yeah, the closing is intentional. In the bedroom. Yeah, I'm pretty sure the game is crashing itself. Yeah, look at this. The game is just glitching every time I run it. But that's ridiculous. Uh-huh. Okay. You know what scares me about games? Visual glitches like this. I actually fucking hate when games do this intentionally. What is that? Yeah, I really don't like scary shapes. This game is full of them. Fucking hate this. Thank you, but no! Completely takes you out of it. Yeah, I can see that. That didn't tell me where to go next, right? I just have to assume. Look at those plates on the ceiling. This is de-resing around you. Yeah. I'm just waiting to see something, like, super spooky. I just, I mean, the shapes are pretty spooky as is. I don't like them. I don't like this. Can't get in that door. We started in the bedroom, right? Yeah. This is just an empty bathroom now. Let's go into spooky ass room. The fuck is this? If the horror is supposed to be you're trapped in an outdated and poorly made simulation, then great, but when it closes itself on you, you're free. That's true. I hate this type of shit. I fucking hate, like poorly, I don't know, shapes. The tapes are neat, if kind of dull, yes. I still don't know what they're going to do at the end of this. That's the sound I made last time I grew teeth all over my body, too. Very good. Hey, Drakenfar. I'm sorry, I still don't have transcoding for some reason. I noticed. I don't- it's super weird. I checked earlier. Do I have to go into the basement? Did I get turned around? What happened there? That door is locked. Okay, That would have been sweet. I appreciate all raids. Where haven't I gone that I can get to? It would have been like 200. Oh my gosh. Oh, here. Yeah, that'd be sweet. I've never been raided with like a huge, huge amount of people. I think the most I've gotten was like 20. That would have freaked me out so bad on top of this game. Oh, wow.
If we were to dissect the house, we would find organs and stomach, brains and minds and eyes. Dreams and memories and a mouth that will bite down.
Oh, fuck. Okay, this room is now... I'm in this room. I don't see the appeal of doing or watching 24-hour streams. It's fine with, it isn't a setting. It's random. Twitch determines based on something that they don't tell us as to whether... Like, partners always get transcoding, but affiliates, it's up to how many other people I think are streaming, how busy their servers are. But there's definitely no setting for it. 24-hour streams, I'm fine doing them for, like, charity and stuff. On a complicated secret basis, yeah. I don't want to go into this basement. Especially because this basement is extremely fucking dark. Is that, like, breathing? Do you guys see anything down here? Is this something that's gonna get triggered when I go back upstairs? It was previously on this wall. I don't see anything, so maybe I should go back upstairs and it'll trigger something. But I hear like wind or breathing or something. I didn't see anything down there, did you guys? Obviously, like, I miss things all the time, right? So. Like ladders, yeah. I'm too chicken to press the buttons that I need to press and do the looking I need to do. Anything, unless it's like on the floor somewhere in the center. No, don't say that. Runaway turtles, it's rude as all heck. I don't like it. I hear noises. Guys, I don't see anything down here. There's a glitchy thing, yeah. But that's it. I don't see any tapes. I assume you guys didn't see anything either, huh?
There is an important distinction that must be drawn between the words dissection and vivisection. A distinction that would appear to be lost on you. Your purpose was to listen, and yet at every turn you have pried, you have prodded, and you have interfered. Have you not been paying attention? Did it not occur to you that as an organism existing within a greater organism, your intrusion would be felt? And still you harassed. And now, like the wayward spider who witlessly settles upon a sleeper's tongue, you will be swallowed. Because the truth is this. When a house is both hungry and awake, every room becomes a mouth.
Love what you've done the place of that real insanity, I see. Very nice. Is my tracking getting worse? Oh, it's nuts in and out.
What happens to a house when it is left alone? When it becomes worn and aged? When its paint peels and its foundations begin to sink? When it goes for too long unlived in? What does it think of? What does it dream? How does it regard those creatures who built it, brought it into existence only to abandon it, when its usefulness no longer satisfies them? It may grow lonesome. It may stare for long hours into the darkness of its own empty halls and see shadows.
Can someone apologize to Dragonfly on my behalf?
Because they can't hear me. I'm not alone. And each time it is wrong, and the hurt starts over, it may haunt itself, inventing ghosts to walk its floors, making friends with its shadow puppets, laughing and whispering to itself at the end of some quiet cul-de-sac. It may grow angry. Basement may fill with churning acid like an empty stomach, and its gorge may rise as it asks itself through clenched teeth, what did I do wrong? It may grow bitter. It may grow hungry. So hungry and so bitter that its scruples dissolve and its doors unlock themselves. While a house may hunger, it cannot starve. And so, in fever and anger and loneliness, it may simply lie in wait. Doors open. Shades drawn. Hallways empty. Hungry.
Runaway turtles. Where did you go wrong? I feel like the first mistake was thinking houses are alive. That's it? That's the whole game? This is not gonna quit on me again? Yeah, I'm waiting. Is there gonna be an end? Or is this it? Do I have to manually close it? I'm still waiting for something fucking scary to happen.